All right, welcome back, my students. And in the next part, we are going to look at classification of riddles. We looked at their function, their importance, and so on. Now, these riddles also have been classified into various groups. And these categories are, we've got riddles that are on people, right? And when an example of this, the white lady is in the office. That's a riddle that's talking about people. And the response for that is Jiga, as we had seen. Then, I pass when Mumia's wives were quarreling. I pass when Mumia's wives were quarreling. So, and the response for that is weaver bugs. Now, those are examples of riddles that will talk of people. Then we've got some riddles that will be about cultural objects. And these include a small gourd full of blood. A small gourd full of blood. Remember, a gourd is a cultural artifact. And what is that? A tick. Then, when I beat my child, people dance. When I beat my child, people dance. So the child beaten is a drum. So, cultural objects. Another classification of riddle is the natural phenomena. Example, what tree has only one thorn? What tree has only one thorn? And the response for that is sisal. And then, a meeting under a rock. You've got the beard, isn't it? A meeting under the rock. So the head is there, is the rock. Under it, we've got that meeting, the beard. So natural phenomena. Then we've got those riddles that we talk of domestic animals. And examples of these domestic animals will be, why have they taken a few for grazing and left so many resting? They have taken a few for grazing and left so many resting. Alright, because what are they? They are sheep droppings. They are sheep droppings. My white mouth cow is shared by all. My white mouth cow is shared by all. Response? Toothbrush. So domestic animals have been mentioned in that type of a riddle. Then we have those that will involve maybe the parts of the body. A small bush inhabited by animals. So if the head have got so many lice, right? It is a small bush. The bush made up by the hair is inhabited by animals. Okay? And then, go around one side of the mountain while I go around the other, but we shall never meet. So the ears, they go this way, then the other one go that way, they will never ever meet. So it's a type of a riddle that's talking about various parts of the body. Then we have those riddles that will be on plants. What tree has only one thorn, right? We say that's a sisal. And then I passed when Mumia's wife were pregnant. Again, it can be millet heads. Millet, you know, we have the sorghum, we have the millet. So millet or her head, I passed when Mumia's wife were pregnant. That's a riddle on plants. Then we have those riddles that will be about modern technology. And the saloon car carrying whites only, so charcoal iron. The saloon car carrying whites only, charcoal iron. And then, how many wheels does a car have? Five. Remember, cars were not then by then, but because of modernity, such kind of a riddle is created. Then we have those riddles that will be about birds, and this is a repeat of what we had. I passed when Mumia's wives were quarreling, and that will be definitely weaver bats. Remember, wherever they are, they make a lot of noise. And then my camel is the shortest, but it eats the tree at the top, a bird. So these are riddles on birds. Then we have those riddles that ask questions. They are called interrogative riddles. So these are riddles that are in the form of a question. Example, what tree has taken a few for grazing and left so many resting? Right? So it's a question, and therefore it needs, it's in a form of a question which requires that response. And then we have declarative riddles. And declarative riddles, these are riddles in the form of a statement. Most of the riddles given below are declarative. So the riddles are going to give you at the end of it, they declare probably how things are. Then we have epigrammatic riddles. And these are riddles that are presented in a series of puzzles. And for example, you've heard about this type of a riddle, or where you are supposed to try and understand. We have a man who have got a goat, who has got a leopard, and also grass. And this person needs to move them from one side of the river to the other one. He has a boat, but this boat can only carry one person or one item at a time. So he, the man, plus either one. So how should he make sure that the goat, the leopard, and the sheep is crossed to the other side of the river? Unfortunately, if you leave the goat with the grass will be eaten by the goat. And if you leave the goat with the leopard will definitely feast on the goat. So that, those are the series of puzzles, or referred to as epigrammatic riddles. Then we have riddles that are based on sound. They are called idiophonic riddles. And these types of riddles are based on sounds, as you have said. For example, when you say see and see, sindano. See and see, sindano. Sindano is a needle in reference to the sound made when the needle is going in and out of the garment. As you are assuming that is the sound probably that's going to be see and see, sindano. And then we have magregede. The way it works, the wagon on the train, it will make such kind of noise. So let's look at a few examples of riddles. Jorge the carpenter is a beetle, very hardworking. You hold and hold, how we cut meat into small pieces. So we have said see and see, sindano, and then it came from Cumberland in a tie, the crow. And then one side of the gourd is white, there are chicken droppings. And then I have gone round the forest with red motorcycle. I've gone round the forest in a red motorcycle, and that is a rainbow. And other examples of these riddles, I went hungry and came back full. I went hungry and came back full. So the small bag for greens, vegetables, and then a winnowing tray in the plane. So an elephant's footprint, and then it is upside down but it does not leak, a cow's udder, right? It's upside down but not there, you will find it leaking, that's a cow's udder. And then the face up as though they are about to lead a song. So the horns of a kettle. And then I have a person who lives between two swords, but they never get cut. Between two swords. The tongue is in between the upper sword and the lower sword, but never cut. Now, we have also proverbs and their wise saying, and we want to look at similarities, or what is similar between riddles and proverbs. Now, both proverbs and riddles are very brief. You have seen they are one line or one sentence. They are never long, so they are very brief. Again, they employ figurative language. You have to think critically so that you are in a position to really understand what is being asked. And then they appear in fixed form. So the way it's supposed to be, it's supposed to be that way. You can't alter it. And then they express some observation of phenomena. So both of them, they talk about the environment where people are, and you find that riddles and also proverbs, they are so much related in one way that they use observation of what is happening in their society or even the environment where we are in. Again, they've got some differences, so that's why a proverb is referred to as a proverb, and again, a riddle is a riddle, so which are these differences that are there. So, riddles are performed in a formal structure and pattern with at least two parties. So remember, the riddle have gone the stages or the levels or the reading process, but a proverb doesn't have that. So on the other hand, when it's come to the proverb, so you find that is infused in speech. As you are speaking, then you put that part of the speech as you are saying it. Then the basic function of riddles is socialization and entertainment. Proverbs, on the other hand, express community wisdom and world view. And then due to what they are used, riddles are performed by children or young people. But you see that riddles or proverbs have been used by adults to show their level of wisdom. So that brings us to the end of that lesson. So thank you very much, and we are going to meet in the next lesson. Have a lovely day.